This is Backspace Diaz, and you're watching GuyDance.
What's up, everyone? It's your friend Backspace, and I'm out here in Chania, Greece, chilling, walking the streets. I thought I'd share some street dance moves because I'm out here in the street. All right. Specifically, I wanted to cover dance moves that cover three beats. Now, some people might be like, what is that? Most hip hop has all types of beats, right? But specifically, there's a very strong beat or tempo within a song. And that goes bum bum bop, bum bum bop. Even if it's a very decorated, you know, highly produced track, there's always that 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And even if it gets complicated, it might be like 1, 2, 3, ba ba da da, 1, 2, 3, ba ba da ba. Or if it's simple, 1, 2, 1 and 2, 1, 2, 1 and 2. And I think that having some three beat dance moves is definitely key to helping you stay on your timing and develop your dance. A lot of people always ask, yo, Backspace, why are you always hitting beats? Or how you dance like that? And like, it really isn't hard. Once you know the certain moves that you got and the certain styles that you do it and the music, you know, you're really like into the music and you love the music, then that part is easy, all right? But right now, I'm just gonna start or give you a quick overview of several dance moves that contain that three beat pattern that we can use, all right? So the first dance move, you probably already learned it if you're familiar with this breaking lifestyle. It's an Indian step. I might have gone through it in other tutorials for other reasons, but right here, this is just a three-step move that's very basic. Now you're right here, and it's just 1, 2, 3. That's all it is. You just jump out and step back. All right, so if you got that 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and you just put it consecutively, and it could match most any music. Now you have that 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. The way that you do it is up to you. All right, so I'm gonna just show you from the back angle so that you can see how that looks. It's just, you're here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And that's pretty basic, pretty easy, but you could do a lot with that and just have some fun. All right. Another dance move that we can use to put that all together, it's a simple pas de bourrée. Now, pas de bourrée is a dance move that is basic. It's a fundamental move, which means that it's very important and it's very useful to have in developing your other moves. Now, with the pas de bourrée, it's a little more trickier for hip-hop dancers because the pas de bourrée dance roots come from other classical dances. So if you ever walk into a jazz class, a ballet class, or any of that, that's one of the dance moves that you may learn right off the bat. And it's very useful move. It's just 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now the way that you do it is up to you. You know, in ballet, they have the arm placement and they have all of that going on. And jazz, it's a similar move. And even in other dances, you know, salsa and hip hop dance itself, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. It all goes together with the three hit. So if you could do that, then that's two moves that you could elaborate on, or should I say two styles? Because once again, you could take that, flip it, and rock it how you want. All right, so for this dance move, you're gonna step behind to the side, and then you're back at the middle. All right, so I'm gonna turn around so you could see what I'm talking about. So you're here, you're gonna step behind to the side, and then you're back at square one, right? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now you have two moves that you could put together. All right, so let's say you have your Indian step And then you have that pas de bourrée step. You could put them together and do a few of one. You could go one, two, three, one, two, three. And with a little practice, you can learn how to feel out which moves feel more fluid and combining them, all right? Because once I finish here, this same leg can start my pas de bourrée, one, two, three. And then depending on where your weight is going, that free foot can just start right into the next step. So for this purpose here, I'll just have an Indian step followed by a pas de bourrée, all right? It would go one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Now, if you do it here, it'll go one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. And you could put that together, have a lot of fun, and you can just, you know, cookie cutter it and develop a lot of moves and put them together like little train sets. Or you can just do the one step and then have all different ways that you could perform that step. And you can hit those beats, or at least get that one, two, three in, and it's a good feeling when it all comes together. All right, now the next step I wanna add is a pretty simple step. It's a lot of fun, it's very hoppy, all right? Because that's basically what it is. It's a hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step. And to some people it might be tricky, and to others, not so much, all right? Now when you do it, it's gonna go hop, hop, step, and that's all it is. And then you're gonna go hop, hop, step. And the way that you do it is really what carries the move. So if you're like hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step, it's not, you know, as exciting to watch or even to perform than when you're getting into your one, two, threes and you're just like one, two, three, one, two, three. So when you do this hop, hop, step, I always think, at least for the basic, you wanna go like left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. With your hop, just think about that pattern while you're going hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step. All right, so when you put that together, it would go dun, 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 dun. So I'm gonna turn around and do the same thing so you can see from the back angle. You'll get that hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step. And you throw all of that together and have a lot of fun with that. And I do hop to the side, but you could do that with anything, even back and forth. Hop, hop, step, hop, hop, step. You could put that all together. As long as you run those patterns with the music, then the magic's gonna happen, baby. All right, so now this next step is gonna be a kickball change. Now that's also a basic step that you will learn in a lot of dance moves. All you're gonna do is kick, you're gonna put your foot down. It's called kickball change because what you're gonna do is you kick, you step on the ball of your foot, and then you change. So that's all it is. It's just gonna go kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change. Now I like to add like a little hop to it because it just makes it more dynamic, all right? So instead of just kick, ball, change, think about jump, kick, ball, change, all right? So kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change. And if you're here, kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change. Now you can have fun with that and just change your arms around and you could develop like a lot of moves. As long as you're doing your kick, ball, change, jump, kick, ball, change, you could do whatever with your arms. Have a lot of fun with that. All right, now this next move, I call it a shakedown because it just reminds me of when you're just like shaking your leg or just like, you know, like shaking things up. This one is probably the most tricky out of all the moves, but it's also one of my favorites. In terms of this three hit counting, it's gonna go boom, 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 boom. This shakedown, I call it a shakedown because you're gonna shake your foot to the outside, then bring it in and then out again. It's kind of like just doing this. But when you have that with the three count, then it looks really fresh, at least to me. All right, so what you want to do is you have your knee in or your foot out. It all depends on how you want to think about it. You're going to go one, two, three. All right, so knee goes in, knee goes out, step. All right, so one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. And to me, it just looks fresh because you're just like, pa, 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 one, two, ha, one, two, ha, one, two, ha. And you can like move directions with it and you could just like come lower. And I've even put up some tutorials using that shakedown and bringing it down and bringing it back up within your footwork. Check that out. I think it's very useful and it looks fresh just coming up and down, transitioning with these dance steps. All right, because everything that you do up top, you could also do it downstairs. So keep that in mind when you're learning all of these moves. And then all of your moves are gonna develop exponentially. It's gonna be dope. All right, so I'm gonna turn around, do the shakedown from the back view for you guys, and then we'll just have some fun putting it together, all right? So when you rock the shakedown, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. All right, now naturally, your foot is gonna, your other foot, the one that's grounded, it's gonna naturally slide on the floor. Just let it slide, that's okay. Because if you try to stop yourself while you're doing all of that, you might hurt something, because I've done that before, all right? You just might tweak something, or you might come up with some new stuff, whatever works, all right? Just be careful when you do these moves while you're having fun. Don't rush any of these. These are nice and easy. One, two, three. One, two, three. I think it's more important that you get the basics down at a normal speed or even a slow speed before you could jump anywhere and get all super hyped and try to like hit every single beat. That's not necessary, all right? Once you have the basics, you develop on that. And then the way that you perform your moves is always gonna shine because there's so many different ways to do it. You don't necessarily need speed to like prove that you're a good dancer, you know? So let's put these moves together and then we'll just have some fun, all right? We'll check you out in a second. Have your three count dance moves that you can utilize and hopefully it helps you grow and develop. All right, feel free to mix and match, add your decorations and do what you got to do with it, and send me some feedback if there's anything that I can do better. I definitely appreciate that because not only are you guys my motivation, but you guys are my teachers as well. Thank you so much for checking this out. Do what you love, love what you do, be inspired. I support you. I love you all more than you'll ever know, and I'll catch you guys soon, all right? Peace.